Hello everyone, how are you today? It's been so exciting this week, this weekend, not even this week, it's just been the last couple of days. I've opened up my social media and Facebook and Instagram and seen floods and floods of people taking part in the Kickstart Your Art Challenge. And Katie, thank you so much for your review on my podcast. Thank you. I checked again and I was like, yeah, I've got another review. Thank you. So I was really excited this morning to see everyone's work from over the weekend. And I felt really inspired and excited by everyone's artwork and everyone's discoveries. And it got me really thinking about art in general and why it is so amazing and how even just looking at it and seeing other people, and I know this sounds weird, but seeing people making mistakes. And after the conversation we had last week with Sharon about making mistakes and how important they are, I see these people making mistakes, myself included, and they are massive lessons. And I almost see people battling with the mistakes, but I've got quite excited thinking, well, that's great that you've made that mistake because you've just learned so much from that exercise. So if you haven't been following, there's a Kickstart Your Art Challenge going on right now. If you want to go and check out the artwork, if you search for the hashtag UAS Kickstart, you will see all the amazing experimental pieces, people who have not made art in over 30 years, who have put pen to paper, pencil to paper, and have started to put themselves out there. There's so many people that have said, I am so scared to post this. I know it's not perfect. I know it's not great, but I want to share it. And this is why I've been doing this for the last 5 years. I started United Art Space 5 years ago for this reason, because it's those first steps and taking the plunge after a break, taking the plunge after a block, taking the plunge just because you need to do something different. And having the courage to do that is so amazing. So I just want to say well done to all of you taking part and being brave enough to share, because I've worked through all these same battles, especially running United Art Space and sharing my own artwork. I've had all the same fears as you, like, what if people judge me based on what art I make? And oh, it's crazy. And actually, what we're doing here is we are literally being aware of what is around us and just letting whatever comes out of us. No judgment. It doesn't matter what the end product looks like. There is so much to learn from the process. So I saw a lot of people criticizing themselves as well, which is normal, and saying, you know, I only took 30 seconds on this one and I should have done this and I should have done that. And, oh, it didn't end up going the way I wanted it to. And all of those things are valid, but don't end there. You know, the whole purpose of this Kickstart and to make art in 10-minute increments is to learn this about yourself. It's to learn, what can I achieve in a 30-second drawing? Do I like the output? If I did it again, how would I do it? So it's such a realization when you don't get hung up on the end result and actually just dissect what you did in that time. Even a splodge of paint, you can learn so much from just that. And this is what I want you to all start thinking about, is as you're filling up your sketchbook with these experiments, it's about really analyzing each part of it, not as a whole, but looking at your line work. And somebody else said to me, they drew three different spoons. And she said, and I really like them, but I don't know why. And that's great. It's a great realization to have, because what you can do from there is start to really question why. What is the difference between this spoon and that spoon? And all of this comes down to visual language. Art is a language. And it's fascinating. And I have been looking at people's artwork and seeing how yesterday the challenge was to do the same photo or same object in three different ways. And there was a great post from Lucy Mills, and she chose a teddy bear and she drew and rendered the first teddy bear in a really delicate, I think it was with pencil. It was all graduated. It was soft. It looked really cute. It looked really vulnerable. And that was the way she used her pencil, so softly, so delicate. And it made the teddy bear feel really delicate and fragile. And then in her second drawing, she used more expressive lines and built up the fur with lots and lots of mark making. And there was lots of mark making around the teddy bear. So in the first one, everything was confined inside the teddy bear. And then the second one, she brought marks outside the teddy bear. And that one, the same teddy bear, but felt so different. It had so much energy. This teddy bear felt quite robust and, you know, like he didn't look cute and fragile. It looked like he or she could handle themselves. And what was different in that piece as well was the eye was drawn around. So there were so many marks going in different directions that was describing the fur. But what was happening was my eye was going all around. So it had, for that reason, because the eye was being led around, it felt more energetic, had more energy. It was completely different. And this is so amazing. This is why art is so amazing. It's all about visual language. And the third piece that she did was a collage, and she put tiny little strips of paper to describe the form of the teddy bear in a collage way. And that one, again, looked really different, but that one really captured the expression of the teddy bear. So it was really, really interesting to see how different, when we use different marks, different materials, how it can be the exact same object, but makes us feel in a different way. One can make us feel really, oh, about the teddy bear, and one's like, wow. So this is why this Kickstart is so, so great, because it starts to get you to really question what you're doing. Again, it's not about the output. It's about, okay, if I did this in 30 seconds, what is good about this? Is there anything good about this? What didn't I enjoy? And what you should start doing is capturing all of that inside your sketchbook. Make notes of, I didn't like this because it made me feel under pressure. I loved this because I stopped overthinking and I realized how much I can actually get done in a 2-minute drawing. I've had lots of people say that to me. That, oh my gosh, I didn't realize how much I can capture in 2 minutes. For other people, it's hard. It's like, I can't capture anything in 2 minutes. And again, there's no right or wrong. It's about you finding your own voice and you learning about how you like to make art. And one thing I wanted to say as well is that through this process, you'll learn about what you want to say. So for years and years, I spent a lot of time trying to replicate what I could see when I was at art school, which is great. You know, it's a great skill to have, to be able to depict and draw exactly what you can see and get all your angles right and render something and get your tonal values and all of that. And I spent years and years doing life drawing classes, doing my art degree, rendering things, measuring, and I found it so hard. Even after years and years and years of practice, I still to this day find it hard. I'm one of these, I have to measure everything. And it was really weird at uni as well. I'd always draw things like I was high up looking down, even if I was at eye level. I could never get the angles right. And what I've learned over the years is it was great to attempt that and to learn how to see and to learn the skills of, you know, if I want to replicate something as I see it, I know I've got to practice and I've got to look at where the lines meet and where, you know, take things out of context. But equally, I don't have to draw or paint in that way. I don't have to replicate what I see. And as simple as that sounds, that was a massive realization and acceptance of myself. I'll never forget when I met an art group once. They said, oh, you know, come and meet us, we can draw each other. And I just panicked because I thought, I can't sit there across the table from you and just draw you in like an hour. It really, that would like hurt my brain. And that made me feel like, oh, does that mean I'm not an artist? Because this art group, that's what they do. And so one of the biggest gifts I've ever given myself is to just accept. And from this process of kickstart is learning what I like and what you like. And what can I take from this little accident that's just happened? You know, I quite like the wibbly wobbly lines. And knowing now that I will often take a reference and it won't ever end up looking like the original, and I don't mind anymore. That's not what I'm making art for. I love taking something like a teddy bear and I will literally use it as a starting point to take me in a completely different direction and take me on a journey. And when I learned that that was okay, and I don't have to render the teddy bear exactly if I don't want to, it was like, oh gosh, this is so much more freeing. So this is what we're doing. We are pushing ourselves. We are trying different things. Try and render something accurately. Try and take it out of context and turn it upside down and turn it into something different. This is where your voice starts to develop as an artist. This is where the real exciting stuff starts to happen. When you don't put the expectations on the final piece and pressure yourself for it to be something, chuck it all out the window and play, that's when you find those little sparks. And somebody said to me, did I write the name down? Somebody said to me, let me just check. Yeah, it was Catherine. Catherine played around with a floral and she said she did it in three or four different ways. And she said, I really like the expressiveness that comes out when I work with my non-dominant hand. So how do I start to combine that with better shaping for my dominant hand? And what an amazing realization. And this was something I realized about my work too, that I much prefer my work when I draw with my left hand, which is my non-dominant hand. And you'll see pieces in the background where I've done that. And actually in my sketchbook, I've worked with my left hand. There's lots of pieces where I've just used my non-dominant hand because I love the line work and the shapes that just come out. When I'm working with my right hand, I think too much. And it was a great question. And what I have done is I do more and more work with my left hand. And this very process of then I look at a particular part of that and ask myself, why do I prefer that part? What is it about the expressiveness that I like? And it sounds like you're noticing that you like the shape when you use your right hand, but you like maybe the line work when you're using your non-dominant hand. And it's these things to capture in your sketchbook. And then when you are working, you can either just use your non-dominant hand every now and again to create that line work that you like. Or what I do, because I'm like you, sometimes I can't get the shape that I like with my left hand. So I will loosely hold the paintbrush or the pencil or the charcoal, and I will literally just loosely hold and do it that way so that it's not so rigid. And again, all of this learning and me holding my brush in that way came from these plays and experiments and looking at something, thinking, why do I like that? Why don't I like that? Why don't I like that shape with my left hand? Okay, so, and this is great. So, Catherine, now you're going to fuse some things together to really create the shape and line work of the flower the way you want it. So it's really, really, really exciting to see everybody starting to just, even if you're not making these discoveries yet, what's happening to you as you are simply getting your sketchbook out and responding to something is you're activating that part of the brain, the creative brain, where it zones out and it starts to notice things. And the act of doing this for 10 minutes each day activates that part of the brain. And people have already started to say already that by doing 10 minutes, it has activated their brain. They're now on a commute and they're noticing things, or they've started to notice recurring patterns already. We're only 3 days in, well, it's the fourth day. And people are starting to notice that they're drawn to the same things. Even if you're not noticing patterns yet, this activation of your brain, it will happen. If you stick with it, you will start to notice things. So it's really exciting. And I just love seeing all the examples and people bringing and sharing their art. And I just think the more we do this, the more it inspires others. I've seen lots of people saying that they haven't had the courage to take part, but they've started to see other people's posting and it's inspiring them to just do it, to just get the materials out. And someone said, I don't have any art materials. You don't need art materials. You can literally, if you've got a tea bag in the cupboard, coffee, you can go and get dirt out of the garden. Sharon often gathers dirt and clay and you know, like the slip from the hills that we walk in. You can really improvise and even just use a pen or a pencil or a biro. I often work with biro. So try not to put pressure on yourself to have all the fancy art materials. You can literally recycle envelopes that come through the door, use newspapers or old magazines. I've seen people literally cutting up magazines, scraps of paper, and starting to make artwork that way. So you can use anything. And sometimes people think, well, what's the point in that? What's the point? I'm not planning on being that artist that cuts things up, but and collages. And the thing is, you'll learn so much from using, like Lucy used lots of cut bits of paper to describe a teddy bear. Now, she might not become a collage artist, but from that act of collaging, she's realized that the expression of the teddy bear out of all the pieces of work was the most, for her, it was the most reflective. And that was what she thought, wow, that's something interesting in that. So why is that? Like, how can I replicate that in my painting? So this is why playing and experimenting, so fun, but also people underestimate the lessons, I think, and what you can learn to put forwards into different types of work. So it's amazing. Keep posting, keep sharing. I'm loving what you're doing. And just remember to keep practicing, but don't dismiss things. Don't look at things and go, oh gosh, that was so rubbish, I should just give up. Know that we're all making mistakes. We're all making rubbish things that we're not happy with, but we're looking at them. Keep making notes in your sketchbook and keep going, keep changing and do it again in a different way. And it's that practice and honing in. This is how people develop their artistic voices, by keep going, keep reflecting and asking yourself the questions. Thank you so much for joining me today. I will head over to the comments now and let's see, how are you all? Simone was saying no email was sent for three. Yeah, we're not sending emails every single day because it actually hurts our email. If we email every day and people don't open them, it causes them then to go in your junk and your spam even more. So we try and stagger and just email every other day. So the link to the Kickstart, which has been emailed to you, if you make a note every day to check that link and to check our social media, it is everywhere. I will be emailing a couple more times this week because we're going to have some extra live sessions with Sharon. We're going to do some art sessions together. So I will be in touch via email to let you know when those will be. Hey Dawn, lovely to see you here. This is so motivating and inspiring. I love the quiet headspace created when sitting with a piece of paper and pencil. Oh yes, I know. It's so nice. Thank you for the encouragement. You're so welcome. It is. It's scary for some people, but I love that way of looking at it. And I think this goes, again, of how we perceive things. And you've obviously got this lovely way of looking at that blank page and thinking, right, now this is my quiet headspace time. And for others, it's like, oh no, this is the page where I've got to get everything perfect and I'm going to just ruin it. And it's so interesting how everything goes back to how we think and react to things, doesn't it? And if we can change that feeling of looking at the first page to being, oh, this is my quiet space where I'm just going to just let rip on the page, it just changes it instantly. It's so fascinating. So yes, put a reminder, Lorna, in your diary to check the challenge each day. Simone says, yeah, I saw some slip sketches Sharon did and tried it in my year three. I was so happy with the result. Yeah, she's great. Sharon's amazing. She will just go on walks and she'll just be like digging up stuff out the ground, and she's a real gatherer, and she's a ceramicist, so she likes dirt and clay and mud and getting messy. I'm a little bit the opposite. I do like getting messy, and in fact when I do make, I do get charcoal everywhere because I love charcoal, and it's usually all over my feet as well for some reason, even though I don't make art with my feet. I don't know why that happens to me. I love this. Karen says, I found I like painting without my glasses on. The view's really fuzzy, and it was fun to paint that way. I like that. So good. Lloyd, try it. That sounds like a good idea, using the left hand. Yeah, I love creating artwork with my other hand. But the problem is now, it's not a problem, but because I do so much with my left hand, it's actually getting stronger. Like when I first did it, it literally was like a 3-year-old, and it still is like childlike, but I have more control now. Because it's, again, practice. The more you practice, the better you get. So I'm now trying to use it less so that I still have that quality of line. It's funny. Jim's saying I can only access Monday Motivational Lives on my phone. Oh, well, they're all through Facebook, Jim, so I don't know why, because it's literally Facebook. Are you in Australia? Because I know Australia have banned certain pages, people. But yeah, Jim, this live isn't anything to do with the hub. This is my weekly live to everyone that gets turned into a blog post. So the hub sessions are Thursday and Fridays. Yep. So that's why this one's different. This is on my page. There is a graphic somewhere, Jim, to show when I'm live and where. So Mondays is my Facebook page. It's a quick motivational live that gets turned into a blog post. And Thursdays and Fridays is the hub. I'm just seeing if there's any. Oh, I like this. Suzanne, I want to learn that I don't have to draw what I see. I still feel inhibited by fear. Thank you for this great encouragement. Yeah, it was one of the biggest realizations for me as well. After years and years and years of studying art and... I'm just going to see if there's any other... It's lovely to see you all here. And like this, I always feel that every mark I make, there is a lovely release of positive energy, a way of connecting my mind physically. Yeah. There is so much more to putting things on paper or materials than we realize. So lovely to see you all. I'm going to head off now. So there will be, this week, there will be another session with Sharon on Wednesday. So we're going to try and do that from her pottery, but the Wi-Fi there is really bad, so we need to test it out. But Sharon's going to join us on Wednesday, and we're going to just hang out and make some art together, and you can ask Sharon any questions about the process so far. And then we'll do another session with Sharon on Friday as well. I just need to hook up with Sharon and see what times she can do. But keep going. And if you have missed days, either go back to the beginning and do it in your own time, or jump in the day that we're doing now. Totally up to you. It's not going to hurt either way, which one that you choose to do. And have an amazing, amazing week, everybody. If you are confused about when I'm live inside the hub, go and ask inside the hub group, and we can send you that graphic to show you when I'm live. And for everyone else, that's related to Kickstart and working with Sharon, I'll send an email to let you know. Okay, thank you for joining me today. I will see you all soon. Take care.